Hi, I'm James, and in this video we are taking a look at this, which is a Dell Inspiron 15-3501 laptop with the Intel 11th Gen Core i3-1115G4 processor. There are other Tiger Lake and I believe Ice Lake variants of this laptop available as well. And we are starting by removing the base. This is a Phillips zero size screwdriver bit. The two screws in the top corners are larger screws, are retained in the chassis, I believe, whereas the rest are removed. All the screws on this system are exposed and just around the bases. There should be none hidden below any stickers or so on. So we start by just removing all of these from the base. And what we should see is these back corner ones, because they are retained, just lift the corners of the chassis out rather than coming out themselves. And this should make it really easy to get our pry tool in to lift the back panel away. So with those removed, we take our plastic pry tool, and what we can see is along the edges here, it is already raised because of these two screws. And we can then hopefully quite easily insert our pry tool, unclip along the back here. And lift slightly. Again, working along the side. Make sure those are fully released by just pulling up and undoing them if they don't come freely. And then just peeling the base of the laptop up, and actually that is one of the easiest that I have found to remove. The fact it lifts it up, so long as you make sure those are free, then makes removing it a really simple task. Once inside the system, our first task then is simply to disconnect the battery, and to do that we are going to get our fingers into the side of the white part of the connector here and gently just ease that connector out. This ensures that there is no power going to the system, so if we have accidentally left it asleep, as opposed to shutting it down before beginning the work, the system is fully off and we are not going to cause any damage. Now, on this system, we actually have very good options for storage. We have our M2 SSD here, and even though it doesn't come equipped with a hard drive, Dell still include the SATA cable, mounting, and screws for mounting a SATA drive into it. So first of all, we are going to look at the the M2 NVMe SSD. So this has this shield over the top of it, which is held in with two screws. So we can therefore remove the drive by removing these, or undoing these two screws. And then with that done, we can pull the drive out of its mounting. The standard drive here is a very small, I believe this is a M230 drive, and if we want to fit a longer M2-2280 drive, we can simply take this drive, slot it in, and then mount it using the end mounting point. The covering for this, I believe, should not be reused because it has a metal mounting point for the screw in here. You could source an alternative version of this, which is designed for M2-2280 drives, but as is, this drive can fit in using that mounting point, and I would not bother replacing that little cover. To add a SATA hard drive to this system, we can then simply remove the three screws which are used for holding in this mount. And lift that out. We can then see that we have a piece of tape which has the mounting screws for the drive in it, and this will take a standard 2.5 inch 9mm thick hard drive or SSD. So we need to just remove these screws. I'm going to pop a 2.5 inch SSD in here, lining up the connector with the cutout in the plastic to ensure it is mounted the correct way, and then screwing it in on the mounting points on either side. With that done, we then just have to remove the tape which holds in this SATA cable, mount our replacement drive, connect the cable, and slot it into position. In terms of memory upgrade, we have two DDR4 SODIMM slots here, and I'm going to remove the standard memory module, which is a DDR4 3200 module, which is interesting because Dell specify this machine as coming with 2666 memory. So what I'm going to do is insert a matched pair of Crucial DDR4 3200 modules, and we are going to see what speed this recognizes in the BIOS. And we need to make sure those are both clipped in, so you insert them, angle, press down, and make sure it is clipped in properly on each side. And what we can see here is, despite the system being outfitted with DDR4 3200 memory, and despite the processor supporting it, the BIOS is locked down, so this still runs at the 2666 or 2667 megahertz speed. So a little disappointing there. You are not going to be able to upgrade this machine to run higher speed memory, even though the processor supports it. In fact, it ships with higher speed memory and just runs at the lower speed. Now, I've actually swapped back, so removed that SSD I fitted there and swapped back the original, because I'm not going to be using those for now, but I have left the memory in, and we just want to refit the back. And with that lined up, we now press along the front to clip this base panel back on, and then screw in the back corners. And then we can simply press that down and replace the screws into the base of the machine. I hope you found this video useful. If you have any questions, of course, please feel free to ask them in the comments below. Hit subscribe if you'd like to see more videos as we post them, and the like button if you found this helpful. Thanks for watching.